In this video, I'll discuss the requirements for your presentation from the article from the Journal of the History of Childhood and Youth. So you see here, I've provided you what I expect for the content and then also what's expected for the voiceover presentation. So you're going to have 5 slides total. That's it. On slide one, you need to have the title of the article, the author, and then why you selected this article. Slide two, discuss the purpose of the article and or the study. So sometimes this will be very clear. They'll say the purpose was. I think so this, if you just finished watching the video before, this is the same article that I was looking at. So here it tells me exactly what this paper is addressing. Now, what I'm not going to do is put this word for word in my slide. That's called plagiarism, and that's not allowed. So what you need to do is read it and then, in your own words, summarize what the purpose of this paper or the study is. So that's on slide two. Slides three through five, you need to have one takeaway or concept that you learned from reading the article. So one takeaway per slide. You can have like the concept written at the top, and then maybe two or three bullets that tie into that concept. One thing that you want to keep in mind, and that I'll be looking for the voiceover piece, is do not read word for word from your slide. So you should give yourself a couple of bullet points that will jog your memory of what you want to say. When I'm listening to your presentation, I don't want to hear a robot. I want to hear you just talking to me. So for more information on the voiceover presentation, so you're going to use PowerPoint. Some of you probably have PowerPoint installed on your computer. If not, everybody has free access to PowerPoint through your UNCW email. So at the top, you have what's called like the app launcher. Click that and you see PowerPoint. You also have Microsoft Word and Excel and things like that, but you have it here also. So no reason this cannot be done in PowerPoint. For to do your voiceover, so if this is my slide one, after I have my content uploaded, then I'm going to go, let's see. So you're going to go under Insert, then Audio, Record Audio. And here I'm going to talk about what I'm supposed to talk about for slide one. So I'm just going to name mine slide one. Then to record, you hit the little record button. Test, test. And then insert it. So now you see a little microphone, megaphone looking thing. Make sure you move it. You can just hold and drag it to wherever, that it's not in the way of your text. And so then when I'm reviewing your slides, I'll be able to hover over it and hit the play button, and I'll be able to listen to your audio. Make sure that you practice that before you submit it. Make sure the audio is there. Okay, and then the last one, just make sure you're articulate, and that, like I said before, you're summarizing what is on your slide, that you're not reading it word for word.